Beginning on July 26th of 2022, a swarm of earthquakes began shaking three islands within American Samoa. Over the next several weeks, an increasing number of quakes were widely felt on the island of Ofu, Olusega, and Tau. Due to a lack of thorough seismic equipment in the area, it was initially difficult to locate where the earthquakes were originating. Regardless, it was almost a certainty that the up to 30 quakes an hour which were occurring, the largest of which were in the upper magnitude 3 range, were magmatic in origin. As a result, the alert level of both the Ofu-Olusega and Tau volcanoes were raised from white to yellow on August 19th. 7 days later, the color code at Ofu-Olusega was downgraded back to white as the quakes were determined to not be originating from this volcano. Instead, they had a single focal point outside the boundary of Tau. These quakes were centered at between 5 and 15 kilometers north of the island of Tau at a depth of between 10 and 15 kilometers. At that very location are a series of two northward-trending ridges which likely represent a chain of underwater volcanic cones. Not much is known about this area, but it would not be all that too surprising if one or more of these vents had erupted at some point in the last 10,000 years. We simply do not know yet, as the water depth in the area is between 700 meters and 2700 meters. This means that at the very shallowest, magma is still slightly more than 7 kilometers below the ocean bottom. And, since the epicenter of the earthquakes had been narrowed down, its location has not further moved. In other words, it is quite likely that whatever magmatic intrusion caused all of this unrest has likely stalled and is not advancing further towards the crust. Thus, while a new volcanic eruption could still occur at a vent to the north of the island, the odds of this are not necessarily high. These odds have further declined as beginning on September 6th, the frequency and rate of larger magnitude earthquakes has continually decreased. Although, as of the making of this video, the number of earthquakes has stabilized slightly. In terms of the broader context, it is unclear what this intrusion might represent. It could simply be an isolated event, or it might signal the first of several magmatic intrusions, some of which might be more likely to cause a submarine eruption or non-submarine eruption onto Tau Island. After all, the area is highly volcanically active, as for example, the adjacent Ofu-Olusega volcano produced a submarine eruption in 1866. However, since the exact record of eruptions at Tau has remained unclear, and the eruptions on land appear to be primarily effusive with some explosive eruptions near water, this volcano was assigned a low threat rating just like its neighbor in the US Geological Survey Volcano Threat Assessment. Two other volcanoes which have approximately the same threat score are Mount Jefferson in Oregon and Craters of the Moon in Idaho. What I am trying to say is that it is quite interesting the volcano ranks so low on the threat assessment, as it ranks 126 out of 161 volcanoes within the country is showing any sign of activity. Typically, volcanic unrest occurs at more active volcanoes such as Okmok, Mount St. Helens, or Mauna Loa. Although it might appear as if the threat is declining, it still remains to be seen if the earthquake storm truly is coming to an end. Thanks for watching. If you would like to request a specific topic, please leave a comment below. Additionally, I would like to thank my new YouTube member, Shirley Shirley, for supporting this channel.